Well, praise the Lord, everybody, and welcome to, again, to Coffee and the Word. Listen, you know, as we head into the Easter season and we prepare to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, I felt it would be good every week if we would take just a moment and look at some of the things that the Lord Jesus accomplished for us through His work on Calvary's cross, because it is through the work of the cross that all redemption comes to mankind. It is because of Jesus Christ becoming the Redeemer on the cross for us that we have righteousness, we have a relationship with God. Everything works through the resurrection. Without the resurrection, there is no Christianity, because Jesus would not be Lord. But in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 1, the Apostle Paul puts great emphasis on this. He says, "Moreover, brethren, I declare to you the gospel which I preached to you," he says, "which also you received and which you stand." In other words, he preached this gospel, they received the gospel, and they took their stand on the gospel of Jesus Christ. What was it that Paul preached? He says, "By which you are also saved, if you hold fast to the word which I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I delivered to you, first of all, that which I also received, that Christ Jesus died for our sins according to the Scriptures." In other words, Jesus fulfilled all Scripture on the cross. He died according to the Scriptures. He did exactly what the Bible said He would do. And he says He was buried. Jesus was buried. He was taken down from the cross and placed in a borrowed tomb. And He was buried there. And it says, "And He arose again the third day according to the Scriptures." Praise God. In other words, he's saying what you and I have to believe and stand on to be saved is that Jesus Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, that He was taken down from the cross and buried in the tomb. Then on the third day, He was raised from the dead, and now He is Lord. And you have to believe that in your heart. Romans 10, 9 and 10 says that with the heart you believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth you confess the Lordship of Jesus Christ. You have to believe He died for you. God raised Him from the dead and confess Him as your Lord. Take your stand upon that, and you shall be saved. You know, it's important to know that when Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, He defeated the devil, He defeated sin, He conquered demons, He overcame the powers of darkness and dethroned Satan and put him under His feet and brought us liberty from him. In fact, over in Hebrews chapter 2, in verse 14, it says this, "Inasmuch then as the children have partaken of flesh and blood, He Himself," Jesus Himself, "likewise shared in the same." In other words, He took on Himself flesh and blood just like you and me, "that through death," notice that, "through His death on the cross, through Jesus Christ taking our place, He might destroy him who had the power of death, that is the devil." Hallelujah. You know, Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians, he said, if the devil had known what he's doing, he would have never crucified the Lord. But through the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, the Lord has triumphed over the devil and destroyed his power of death over you and me. And he says, "and He has released those who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage." You don't have to be afraid of dying anymore. If Jesus is your Lord, you have eternal life. Death cannot separate you any longer from God. Jesus Christ has come and destroyed Satan's power of death off of your life. And if you call upon the Lord, death will be swallowed up with the life of Christ. And death will lose its victory and its hold over you. And you can be free from fear. You can be free from bondage. You can get set free from all of these things by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. But let's look one other place. In Colossians chapter 2, he says in verse 15, "and having disarmed or spoiled principalities and powers," he's talking about demon forces, "He made a public spectacle of them." He made an open show of them, triumphing over them in the cross. Hallelujah. So the Lord Jesus Christ, through the resurrection, defeated the devil, destroyed his power of death. He cannot keep you in sin. He cannot keep you from God. Grace does now abound where sin did. And we have grace in Christ, grace in His work, and the demon forces of hell can no longer override or overrule. You have authority today. You can be saved and live a righteous life because of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. So let's begin to celebrate this entire month. Let's celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and let's rejoice in our salvation in Him. And let our light shine. Let's let everybody know that you can get set free from sin and death by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. And as you do, I believe this Easter season will be a great time of resurrection power, reviving, renewing, and restoring of all that God has done for you. Amen? So receive it. Let's walk in it. Let's rejoice in it. Until next time, I'm praying for you that God's very best will be yours.